Hey Cafe crew, today we're going to quickly talk about a subject that confuses a lot of photographers: white balance, specifically temperature and tint. What's the difference? We're going to have a look, but we're also going to explore a new feature which is in Photoshop beta. So let's jump in. So before we get into an explanation of white balance, let's have a look at a long overdue tool inside of Photoshop. Right now this is just in Photoshop beta. So if we go down to the adjustment layer, you'll see at the top color and vibrance. This used to be vibrance. And you'll see there's two sliders here now, temperature and tint. This is what we're going to be focusing on. You might be thinking, okay, what's the big deal? We've had temperature and tint in Camera Raw for quite a while. Yeah, we have, but we haven't had them native inside of Photoshop. Temperature and tint are not the same. Let's start with temperature. This slider controls the balance between cool and warm light. Move it to the right, the image gets warmer with yellows and oranges. Move it to the left, it gets cooler with blues and cyans. These numbers actually come from physics measured in Kelvin. It's the same scale scientists use to describe the color of heated light sources. So when you warm up your photo, you're mimicking lower Kelvin light, like a cozy tungsten bulb, or even all the way down to like a candle. And then when you cool it down, you're mimicking higher Kelvin light, like open shade. Now, it might seem counterintuitive, or going to a lower Kelvin for the warmer colors and a higher Kelvin for the cooler colors. If you start with a flame and you put a piece of steel in there, it's red. As it becomes hotter, it becomes to a whitish blue. So the good news is you don't have to memorize all these numbers in order to correct your images. They can easily be fixed inside of Photoshop right now. So in Photoshop beta, go to the adjustment layer. At the top, you'll see color and vibrance. So this particular image is too warm. The easy way to tell is look for an area that should be white or neutral gray and ask yourself, what color is there? You've seen this look a million times. It's going into the yellows and oranges. So if we go onto the temperature slider, you can see to the right we warm it, to the left we cool it. So all we do is drag into the blue to cool it down. And as you can see, we can easily just roll away the color cast. And yes, we've been able to go into Camera Raw for a long time and do this. But to be able to just adjust a simple temperature slider inside of Photoshop is well overdue. And it has many uses, particularly if you've got split color and different things like that you need to work with masks. And another way to do this is to just grab the eyedropper tool. And we look for an area that should be white or neutral and just click. And that's going to fix the color cast. And we've been able to do this for quite a while inside of Photoshop. If we go under curves or levels, just choose levels, grab the white balance tool and click. And we can correct it. Notice, however, though, doesn't work quite as well as the new one. Next up is tint, and this one's easy to overlook. It doesn't make the photo warmer or cooler, it just between green and magenta. Think of it as your fine-tuning knob for weird color casts. And things like fluorescent lights can definitely add some green into the image. So if we look at the tint and we take that green and move it towards the magenta, notice we can roll off that color cast. But quite often, the issue could be with both. Let's take a look at this image. If I cool this down, that's definitely helping. But notice it still has a little bit of a green color cast. So if we go into the tint as well, now we can roll off those issues. So having this inside of Photoshop is extremely handy. So if you look at the color wheel here, forget the triangle in the middle, but if you look, you can see we've got our blue to orange on the opposite side. So as we're moving backwards and forwards on this axis, we're warming or cooling it. But look what happens when we go up and down. We've got the tint. There's a green to the magenta. Let me show you another example in Camera Raw. All right, so if we have a look at this raw file that I shot, we can see the white balance is as shot. So the white balance settings, if you have a RAW file, you're going to see these settings that are the same ones on the camera. So you're not going to see these on other formats other than the RAW file. So these white balance settings are used to counteract the different type of lighting. For example, this was shot under tungsten lighting. Yeah, it was a little while ago, and I still have some of those lights. But if we choose tungsten, notice immediately it fixes the color cast, because what it's doing is it's compensating for that tungsten. The tungsten is a warmer light, and notice it pushes that temperature to a cooler amount to give us a nice proper white balance. And of course, we could go in and we could adjust the exposure a little bit if we wanted. Let's go under the color grading, and I'm just going to choose the midtones. And the reason I want to show you something here is what we've been looking at. Remember when we talked about warmth? So if we go across this color wheel, one side we're getting warmer, the other side we're getting cooler. But watch the other axis if we go up or down. Now we're going between the green and the magenta. So if you think about it, this is temperature, this is tint. So now you know the difference between temperature and tint. Now, if you want to know the difference between vibrance and saturation, check out this video here. And I'd love to know your thoughts in the comments underneath. And if you're new, welcome to the cafe. Hit the subscribe button and turn on notifications. You won't miss any of my tutorials. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.